Chitradurga Entrance 7. You are now at the 7th and final entrance of Chitradurga Fort. Till here, the fort is mainly military in nature. Most of the army was concentrated in the fort area between the 1st entrance and the 7th entrance. But beyond the 7th entrance, the life of the village people of Chitradurga started. Walk inside, and you will reach a spacious, open ground with various structures visible here and there. This is the heart of Chitradurga Fort, or the town square as they say. People would assemble here and spend their time wrapped in the serenity of this area. The first structures to catch your eye will be the two stone pillars that are joined at the top by a horizontal stone slab with further carvings and sculptings atop it. The pillars are placed on an elevated stone platform which is also beautifully decorated at the ends. Move towards the structure. Do you see the metal hook-like structures constructed at the top of these pillars? This was used as a swing. Once all the pujas were done for Goddess Parvati, her idol was taken and then placed on the swing. This custom is called the Munjal Seva. In front of the swing, you can see a tall, monolithic stone pillar with a white base. This is the Deepastambha, or the lamp pillar. In earlier times, rope ladders were placed against this pillar, and someone would climb up all the way to the top to light the lamp. If you look closely, you can see the topmost part of the pillar where the lamps would be lit. Another interesting structure that you can see near the pillar is the step well. It is a few meters away from here to your right. This well would be filled with colored water during festivals like Holi that used to be celebrated at Chitradurga Fort. Just behind the Deepastambha is the famous Ekkanatheshwari temple. Take the steps that lead up to there and let us meet there.